So since today is the 10th birthday of Kid, it is actually today, I'll tell you why I think it is today later. But so since it's been 10 years of Kid, we thought we'll start with a very brief history of Kid. It's actually only 10 years, not much has happened, no wars, not a lot of conflict. So it's going to be quite short. I'm Sahil, I work at Autodesk as a web developer. You can find me on GitHub and Twitter. _ because if you don't, you'll find somebody completely different. So Git was made by some guy named Linus. I don't know, some of you might have heard of him. He's made this little piece of software called the Linux kernel. Turns out it's pretty big, and what happened was that in 2002, they started using this version control system called BitKeeper for it. And 3 years later, some open source developer decided to reverse engineer it, and the creator of BitKeeper wasn't happy, so he told the Linux people they can't use it anymore. And Linus said, well, you know, we don't have anything else that's good enough for our needs, so let me make one myself. And on 8th April 2005, we have the first commit of Git. And you can see it on GitHub, actually. The reason why it's 8th April is because we are in GMT plus 8. So today is actually the birthday of Git. So this one is pretty interesting, actually. It's only 11 files, 1,000 lines, and he can already commit Git using Git to talk about Git. In the very meta. So in the README, he talks like about what it is. He explains how the object database and cool things that Bob will tell us about work. It's pretty long. Actually, I think half the 1,000 lines might just be the README. Yeah. And then he announced it on the Linux mailing list. They're talking about some other version control system called Monotone. And then Linus is like, you know, I have something really nasty but also very fast. Take a look at it. And if you can do something with it, you get a gold star. Yay. So this was on, I think, 7th April. Yeah, so that's when he first announced it. And, oh yeah, in the README, you can actually see he calls it the stupid content tracker. And this is a screenshot of the manual page for Git today, and that's still the same. It's still the stupid content tracker. This is interesting. How long did it take? It took him about a day to get the first version of it ready, which let him commit Git using Git to talk about Git. And yeah, it's pretty cool. Although he said that he put a lot of thought into it before he started the coding part of it. So like getting the data and what features it needed to have and all those things. Which is pretty interesting because it's nice to see that, like, you know, you should maybe think a lot about your software before you start coding, and then the coding might not even take much time. So in April he announced Git. In July, this guy, Junio Hamano, he works at Google now, he took over the project. He was like a very major contributor to the project in the intervening months. So Linus, you know, he likes control, but he thought, let me give it over to this guy for once, and it turned out to be a good decision. In December, Git 1.0 was released, and it's actually they call it a minor release because it didn't do anything. Some fixes and some comments and things. They had already been using it for the Linux kernel for the past 6 months, so it was pretty stable already. And yeah, in March 2014, which is last year, Git 2 was released. They had some breaking changes there, you guys know. So why Git? This is typical. That's what it means in British English, an unpleasant or contemptible person. And apparently that's what Linus thinks of himself too. So that's one thing he had to say about it. The other three, he gave like these other explanations of why it's called Git. They're in the README file that I showed you. So it's a random three-letter combination that's not used by any Unix program, or it's the second one, or it's global information tracker when you're feeling like really good and you like Git. Or it's a goddamn idiotic truckload of shit when it breaks. So these were the design goals he had. He wanted to be fast, simple, strong support for branching, distributed, because the Linux kernel, that's the kind of model they were already following, and strong safeguards against corruption. And then this very interesting other design goal, which is take CVS, which was like a really popular version control system at that time, and do everything the opposite of how it could do it. He didn't like that at all. It was totally centralized, not distributed. Branching took centuries. So yeah. Another thing he said about it was that he really designed it coming from the point of view of a file system person. And turns out that file system developers think about complex things like this, which might explain why Git is so easy. That's basically most of what I have. It's gained in a lot of popularity. That's 2005 when it started. It's 2015. And Atlassian actually has this nice blog post showing an entire timeline. I didn't want to rip it off, so you can just see it on their website. Talk about when Git was released, GitHub, pull requests, a lot of stuff all the way to today. Oh, they have this nice graph about Git meetups around the world. I can't really see it, but I think there's a little flag that should be here now. Cool. That's basically it for me. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.